the screw back, okay? Some people can pick it up really quick, and some people can never do it. For the beginners, I would try to give them a better practice, a better way of getting to that action quick as possible. The action is actually holding the chips at the very edge, half the chips there, this on the middle of it probably. Well, you hit it to the layout, whatever. Once you hit it, but don't let go like that. You know, you hit it, keep holding it, and as you hit it, you keep pushing it down like you're doing a spin. See, the fingers don't let go until you get there. Then you let go. See, I'll show you. It goes down. Well, I don't just let go when I hit the table. I hit the table, I carry on moving my fingers down. When you're moving your fingers down, it's quite got a relaxed movement. It's not, you're not keep holding it tight and trying to go down. You won't go down because you hold it too tight. Once you hit the table, you relax your finger a bit. So therefore, the chips can spin and your finger can go down. That's the action. Hit it and carry on with the finger and thumb, but not tightly. Yeah? Give it a bit of relax, so you do get a spin action. But to speed it up, the way to do it, well, I would use a stack of something, or chips or something. I'll put it on a block, maybe a plastic block, something that's flat, so you've got a bit of height. So you can have the action hitting the chips and you still follow it down, because it's natural, you hit it and you follow it down, because it's got that gap at the bottom for you to follow down. Then if you can get that right, your chips can come back, then you've got it, you've got action. But from there on, you can do the spin. But to practice, to start with, that would be the best way to practice. And this is what I call a stay off the cliff. This is the easiest one to do a screw back or spin back or backspin. Okay. Yeah, once you master that, spin.